Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for making your time today for the celebration of the Memorial Mass for Sri Oscar Fernandez. A couple of things that we would like to do before we begin our service is a few housekeeping rules. We still understand restrictions are on, but if you're from the same family, then you're okay. If you sit down, you don't actually have to have a mask on. If you can't social distance, it's important to try and keep your masks on. If you need to use the restrooms, just on the left-hand side, and the notice that the restrooms are available, please make avail of those. This is a Mass for celebration. I understand that some of you may feel quite strange as to how things proceed. Don't worry. Everyone is welcome to participate. Father Peter will call upon you to sing, to say the prayers. All you have to do is look at the screen. The words are there, and you can say them. Keep in mind, as we pray for Oscar Fernandez today, we're also praying for ourselves, our families, our relatives, and anyone and everyone that we know or is somebody that might need our prayers. Prayers are a very important thing, especially in these times of a pandemic. Lastly, as we do, we have a service called Communion that is usually given to anyone who's baptized within the Catholic community. Now at that time, what happens is we receive the body of Christ that is provided to us. Now if you're not Catholic, it's still okay. You can come up, but when you do come up, just put your arms across your chest and Father Peter will say a blessing on you. If you feel you don't want to come up, that's okay too. Right? If you do want to receive communion or you want to receive your blessing, if you are not Catholic, just remember, arms across your chest and Father Peter will be able to bless you. Right? Welcome again to the celebration, and soon we shall commence this Mass.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I invite you to please be seated. Our brother Oscar Fernandez has gone to his rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with him. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. I now invite Dr. Bernard Mallick to come forward to share some thoughts and words with us.
We are here to offer a memorial mass in honor of a great man, Mr. Oscar Fernandez. We grieve him because we loved him, but as Christians, we celebrate a life well lived. He lived a faithful life to his Lord and Savior. I remember in 2004, or rather 5, he came to US to stay some time with us. And the first thing he said after arriving home, where is the church? Because he used to go to Mass every morning. We in fact found a new church for him, and he was there regularly as long as he stayed there. In his life, he became a legend. He left a little too early, 80 years old, but in 80 years, he probably lived 800 years. You could always see him sitting till probably 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, till he had met the last man at AICC's office in New Delhi. He was one of those people that never had a no for anybody who walked in. We come from a country where culture of sifarish is there. You need to have recommendations to meet somebody or get things done. For sir, you needed no recommendation. If you showed up at AICC after 10 o'clock, he would meet you. He would write a letter for you. He would make the call for you, whatever you needed. He would hug you, ever smiling, never refusing anything, all the time. I remember when he became road and transport minister, had gone from here, and he did not carry any phones ever. My association goes back with him since 1993, before I went to US. And we were waiting at his home. It was one of the student union presidents that took us to him. We were waiting at his home. A young man walked in. I call him young. At that time, he was always young. He would catch young people, pat them at the back, encourage them, play kabaddi, play wrestling with them, even in his office. He walked in with his trademark bag, that used to be a big bag like this, and a Jeep. And the Jeep had been given to him by Mr. Rajiv Gandhi. The Jeep still stands at his house to this day. And of course, I did not see him later when I met him after years with that bag, but a simple man. So we went and said, sir, my brother needed passport. It was delayed because we applied, and I'm sure those who are from India and are as young as I am would know getting passport was much harder than getting visa. So we said, sir, my brother who was with me said his passport is delayed. He said, no problem. He goes to kitchen, he makes tea for us, and then he comes back, calls Salman Khurshid, who was at that time foreign minister for state, and says, oh, my friends are here, their passport is delayed, can you put it? He says, yeah, tell them to come to my office. And then we went to his office, and the passport officer in Delhi used to be Mr. Chadha. He called Chadha, we go there. Our passport was issued. Never met him again for years until it was Krishna Jayanti, 2000 years of Christ in Bangalore. I saw him again. I said hello to him. I said, sir, do you remember we came? Yes, yes, he remembered. He met me as if he was my old friend. A great memory. That is mark of a great leader. They would remember you even after years. Photographic memory. I met him a little while, and then when he was given the award in United Nations, he came. We had the privilege of hosting him. And then the story again comes back from where I started. When he was the Minister for Road and Transport, I go to India. I met him in his office. I just walked in. He stood up. He said, hello. What are you doing today? He said, kuch nahi. He said, okay, you come home, I'll cook dinner for you. So I went home. He actually cooked dinner. It's not like somebody else cooked. He cooked dinner. We sat probably till 10 o'clock. And his trademark sentence used to be, are you here? Koi kaam hai? I would say, no, sir. Koi kaam hai to bata do. I said, nahi, sir, kuch nahi. At that time, I was waiting. He would ask me, koi kaam hai? I said, yes, sir. He said, sir, ek university banani hai. I want to establish a university. Where? I said, Rajasthan. So he picks up the phone. He calls Ashok Gehlot, who was the CM then. He says, I have a friend here who wants to establish a university. Can you see him tomorrow morning? He said, yeah, yeah. I take my breakfast around 8:30. Tell him to be here 8:30 because after that there is no time. It gets really busy, so this way we can have a good conversation. Next morning, me being me, I missed the flight because the ticket I booked was for the day after when I show up at the airport. Meanwhile, CM's office kept calling me. I said, I'm sorry, I think I booked the wrong flight. He says, no problem, you come. He comes in the evening to Delhi to see me. That was the cloud Mr. Oscar Fernandez carried. That is how he looked after his friends. He would call me after that. Is everything going smooth? Do you need any help? I would like, you know, a little child run to him and say, sir, can you call CM? Can you call this guy? He would call. And when Ocean got married, I said, sir, and you see our political culture. I said, sir, Ocean's marriage is there. Koi zimmedari laga do. He said, yeah. Aap pahunch jao wahan pe. I want you to come. So I went there. He always treated me like a little baby, and I would run to him like that. He was always kind, exceptionally kind. One of the stories I'll tell you of a profile of a great man, the way he used to think. Last time when I met him, it was I think 2019 at his residence. When I walked in, there were probably 400 to 500 people sitting there. Luckily, his staff knew me, and they would always, whenever I went there, they were always very kind. When I walked in there, Mr. Oscar Fernandez said, to people who are waiting, can you wait a little bit? I go to his room, he was sitting there. I said, sir, you are busy, I will take leave, and I can come back later. He said, no, we sit 10 minutes, we'll have dinner afterward. I sat for probably 5 minutes, one guy walked in. Without knocking, push the door open. Young man, probably 35 years old, and he came in. Sir, sign this. So, sir smiled and signed. Said, I also need money. So he had that traditional kurta he used to wear. He put his hand there, took out all the money he had. It was only 500 rupees. He gave it to him and kept smiling. And I asked, sir. I said, who is he? He smiled and he said, his father used to work in military. He said he died. This is the only son. Mother doesn't have a job. And he said, all I try to do is honor his father's services to the nation. So I try to look after him. That was the caliber of a man that we have lost. I think Congress and our country was very fortunate that he brought a different culture to the country. He brought assurance for every man who didn't have anybody. He was there for everybody who had no connections in Delhi. You could walk in.
For me personally, he was a great man, a great inspiration. Last time when I was there, I still have a picture. I said, sir, I like to sit at your feet. I said, no. Aise nahi karo, upar aao. So I said, it's fine. No. He pulled me up, made me sit next to him. And apparently he was pretty weak. I think he was still going through his medication. When I left, I quietly prayed that, Father, we need him for many more years. Give him healing. And God has his own plans and timing. I think his family is here too. I have had the privilege of meeting his wife, his kids, a great, wonderful family. All of them are very faithful to their calling in public life. I asked him, I said, sir, will anybody follow you in your family in terms of your public service? He said, nahin, unki marzi hai, I won't promote anyone, but I am here to serve. You don't find many people in our culture that are so high profile in public life and still remain humble. Sir, we miss you, God bless you, and we pray that you have gone to the right place with your Lord and Savior. Thank you.
Though they die early, will be at rest. For old age is not honored for length of time or measured by number of years. But understanding is gray hair for anyone, and a blameless life is ripe old age. There were some who pleased God and were loved by him, and while living among sinners were taken up. They were caught up so that the evil might not change their understanding or guile, deceive their souls. From the fascination of wickedness obscures what is good, and roving desire perverts the innocent mind. Being perfected in a short time, they fulfilled long years. For their souls were pleasing to the Lord, therefore he took them quickly from the midst of wickedness. Yet the people saw and did not understand, or take such a thing to heart. That God's grace and mercy are with his elect, and that he watches over his holy ones. The word of the Lord.
Now let us read the psalm together. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing else to want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in the green pastures. He leads me to my still waters. He restores my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing else to want. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I
does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For a while, we were still weak. At the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we still were sinners, Christ died for us. Much more surely then, now that we have been justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath of God. For if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, much more surely, having been reconciled, will we be saved by his love. But more than that, we even boast in God through our Lord Christ Jesus, through whom we have now received reconciliation, the word of the Lord.
Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord. Invite you, please be seated. Let's be honest, on a day like today, on an afternoon like this, you really don't want to be listening to me, do you? If Dr. Malik had another 20 minutes of material, then if he had another 20 minutes? Possibly not. In that case, you're stuck with me because I have a microphone and it's kind of my job. But I'm serious when I say that the stories that you share with each other about Oscar Fernandez are crucial in our celebration of his life. They're crucial in our giving thanks to God for his life. And they're vital in us saying farewell. The stories that you tell, whether they're in a professional sense or whether they're meeting through faith, through church, or anything like that, or even if they're just what might seem like legends that you've heard over the years, they form the core of our celebration. Not just in a sense that these are things that Oscar said or did and we think they're great. That that's only the first step. If these stories, some that Dr. Malik shared with us today, if these stories stay just memories, then we're kind of missing the point, aren't we? I'll tell you why I mean that. This gospel reading, you can tell that I was reading it, I made a few mistakes, because I read this reading all the time, a slightly different translation, when I'm anointing someone who's sick, someone who's dying. And the bit that comes into people's minds and in their attention, something that they know, is that, come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. We believe that through the celebration of Mass, the celebration of the Eucharist, we come together because we want to become more like what we receive. We want to become more like Jesus Christ. Now that doesn't mean just watching or spectating, that means doing. And that's what this yoke is. We know what it's like when we're carrying something heavy, and then someone appears randomly from around the corner, oh, let me help you with that. The relief. Jesus does this for us in a sense, but as we were talking with the pastor, as just before Mass, Jesus doesn't share this burden through magic. Jesus shares this burden through our actions. So at Mass, we come together to become more like Jesus Christ, but that happens by us sharing each other's burdens, by becoming more like Jesus and doing that. Sharing a burden sometimes can be as simple as helping someone carry a table. Right, or something a little bit heavier. But from what I can tell, someone like Oscar Fernandez shared the burden, not just of items or things that we can see, but a far more intangible burden that nevertheless felt very real, right, and were very real and are very real for many people across the world. It has been affected by that, but especially in India. The burden of hope. Hope for a future. When we're anxiety, the burden of anxiety, wondering what's going to happen. We have something that needs to be done. We're used to politicians just dismissing us. And we turn up and we have a man in Oscar Fernandez who takes the time. It goes above and beyond, yeah, it sounds like. To listen, to be present, to share that burden. Right? The burden of hope, the burden of anxiety, the burden of suffering, right? The burden of being unsure about the future. People, we can do this. We can share this burden with each other, but it takes a very special person to stand up in front of people, open themselves to all sorts of attacks from people as a politician, but to still make this simple sharing of burdens real. It becomes real when we do things. We don't just listen to people, but we do things. We make that phone call, we send that letter, we contact that person. We go out of our way to do something. That's when it becomes real, because we do things. It sounds so simple, but yet it's so hard. It's hard to share people's burdens when we ourselves are hurting. It's hard to share people's burdens when we are exhausted, or in a bad mood, or when we've had a horrible year or decade. So we look to people who have shared people's burdens successfully for inspiration. So this comes back to what I said before. Yes, today is a perfect day. Whatever country, whatever time zone that you are participating with us today, It's a perfect day to share stories. But let that be only the first step in our celebration of Oscar's life today. Let us then take these stories, implant them in our hearts, and then go out into the world to do something about them. That's how we celebrate Oscar's life, through our actions, not just words or memories. They're great, don't get me wrong, they're wonderful, but they're only a starting point for what happens next. And the great part about that, it means our celebration of his life, our thanksgiving for his life, can continue for many years to come. He was taken, he left us, he went to God too soon. But we are still here, with his example, ready to go out into the world to see and do what is good and right, to serve one another. Christ is the good shepherd who gives his life to save those he loves. In our loss, let us turn to him and with confidence make our needs known.
In baptism, Oscar Fernandez was given the pledge of eternal life. Lord, may he now be admitted to the company of the saints. Your response? Lord, hear our prayer. Oscar Fernandez fought the good fight. Lord, he finished the race. He kept the faith. May he now receive from you the crown of eternal glory. Your response? Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who cared for Oscar Fernandez, Lord, continue to bless them with kindness and patience. Your response? Lord, hear our prayer. For all who knew and loved Oscar Fernandez, Lord, may we draw inspiration from his life. Your response? Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, Oscar Fernandez's family and friends seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. Your response? Lord, hear our prayer. For all of us gathered here, that we may remember at all times, but especially at times of trouble and anxiety, that we are loved by God, and that he will take care of us. Your response?
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all who are sick, may the Lord fill them with courage and give them strength. Your response?
Lord,
hear our prayer. For our deceased relatives and friends, Lord, bring them into the light of your presence and give them a share in your glory. Your response?
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, into your hands we commend the soul of our brother, Oscar Fernandez. Look gently upon him and bring him home to your kingdom, where death will be no more. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We're about to enter into our celebration of the Liturgy of the Eucharist. For those who may be unfamiliar with our celebrations, there are lots of words and things that we say, stand or seat or kneel. Do not worry if you're not familiar with these things. Just your presence here today, whether you're here in this Church of the Holy Cross in Bullman, or whether you're far across the world watching online, just your presence, your connection in prayer is what's important. And you don't have to kneel. If you're more comfortable sitting rather than kneeling, you're certainly most welcome to do so. Thank you.
who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him, the hope of blessed resurrection has come, that by understanding, by the search of divine, might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. You are indeed holy, O Lord, fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, Lord, so that they may become to us the body and blood of our Lord. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul will be healed. Thank you. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body and food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Oscar Fernandez may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto Oscar, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. And may the peace of God, which is beyond all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in the peace, love, and life of Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God.